The establishment of regular prayer, which is our link with Allah. Five times daily prayer, organizing our day around the remembrance of Allah. Maintaining that contact. This is the basic. If we believe in Allah truly, then that is automatic. We don't even question why, how many times, so many times. No, we recognize this is a minimum. This is not all that we should do in terms of prayer to Allah, but this is a minimum. This is to maintain, for us to maintain an even keel, a correct balance in our life as believers. Furthermore, we are enjoined to establish regular charity. We pray what is compulsory for us once a year, and we also give voluntarily to those who are in need, various Islamic causes, etc. We are constantly, you know, sharing what Allah has given us with others, because we believed in Allah truly. We trusted in Him that whatever we give for His pleasure, Allah will return to us tenfold to 700-fold to, you know, as He wishes. But we will be gaining, our reward will be increasing, our benefits will be increasing for that, from that money, though in practical terms our money is decreasing. And Allah closed that verse by talking about the reward. That the reward would be that Allah would provide for us in paradise. The reward for such, those whose hearts are touched by the mention of Allah's name, who put their trust in Allah, establish regular prayer and regular charity, such individuals who are true believers will get the reward which Allah has promised of paradise, the ultimate reward for living a righteous life. And he went on to quote a hadith, a statement of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which was recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari, which speaks of the comprehensive nature of the faith, wherein the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was quoted as saying that faith has over 70 branches, and that the highest of the branches, or the most important of the aspects of faith, is the declaration of faith, La ilaha illallah. And that the lowest branch, which is still a part of faith, is the removal of harm from a path, an action. We see some glass, a nail, whatever, in the path where people walk or whatever, and we take that thing, we move it from the path. This is the lowest branch of faith. And he went on to say that shyness, modesty, is a part of faith. So in expressing that, the Prophet Muhammad was calling us to the realization that the faith covers all aspects of our life. And there is really nothing too small of righteousness that we could ignore doing. Anything which we can conceive as being good, to do that is a part of faith. And he went on to quote another statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is recorded by At-Tirmidhi and An-Nasa'i, that the believers are one who the people feel safe from with regards to their wealth. There is another statement which he said also, that the believers are one from whom the Muslims are safe from their hands and their tongues. In other words, a true believer is one who does not hurt the rest of the community by his tongue, that is, by backbiting, telling lies, slander, etc., etc., spreading rumors. This is not the acts of a true believer. Nor does he hurt them by way of his actions, his physical actions, by taking their wealth unjustly, by cheating them in business, selling them products which they know to be defective, etc. You know, in their actions, they do not harm the believers, nor in their speech. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was also recorded as saying that none of us truly believes until we love for our brothers what we love for ourselves. This is the completion of faith, that our actions represent or manifest our love for our brothers, that we love for others what we love for ourselves. What is pleasing to us, we try to do for others. What is displeasing to us, we avoid doing to others. And he also, the Imam also quoted another statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he had said that none of us are true believers also until we love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than our parents, our children, or all of mankind. Again, as we spoke about this concept in the previous Jummah, that this is one, a love of obedience, wherein we would give precedence to obeying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam over obedience to any of mankind. This is the highest expression of that love. As Allah said in the Quran, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. If, this is for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to tell the believers, if they are truly loving Allah, seeking the love of Allah, then that should be done by following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah will love them. We earn the love of Allah by obeying the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because he was the intermediary between us and Allah in terms of bringing the final message to us. This was the role of the prophets. They were the intermediaries between Allah and mankind in terms of conveying that message, not in terms of worship. Because of course, in terms of worship, there are no intermediaries. We worship Allah directly, and this is what the prophets all told us to do. This is what Allah conveyed to the prophets to tell us to do. So they were intermediaries in terms of conveying the message. Allah chose them as examples for us to show us how we should apply that message. The revelation which came was practically demonstrated for us. This was the role of the prophets. And we respect them, we show our love for them because of that particular role. Not because they are from our tribe. For example, we're Arabs and Prophet Muhammad was an Arab, or we're Jews and Prophet Musa was from the Jews, or you know, whatever. This is not the reason why we love the prophets. We love them because Allah chose them to carry the word of truth and righteousness to us. Then the Imam went on to quote another statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to faith, in which he said that the most perfect believer in faith is the one who is best in character. Again, the one whose faith is most perfect is the one whose character is best. In other words, where there's no separation between faith and actions. Those people who tell us we are believers, we are Muslims, but we find in their actions that they are prejudicial, they scorn people, they curse people, their actions are that of bad character, of evil character, where we see even the non-believers expressing you know, their character is of a better, of a higher level than the so-called believers, such individuals are not true believers. Their faith is in question. We cannot